Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Tattletales. Here we go. Today, Tattletale Quickies. Quickies all day long. We have a studio audience divided into three sections, ready to win some money. Let's meet our celebrity couples. Shall we do that? First, on my left, the blue section is rooting for the boy in blue, composer, writer, singer, Fabian, and his wife, Katie. Katie, you look... Are you in blue, too, Katie?
I'm in blue.
Oh,
I'm not
boy.
Blue, but I'm in blue.
No, don't be blue. You're doing terrific.
No, she's all right.
Too pretty to be blue. Next to Fabian and Katie, the yellow section will be rooting for Dr. Rosewall and his lovely wife, for Marcus Welby. I really should say Rosie Rosewall. That's what it should be, shouldn't it? We call you Rosie for short, right? Rosie and Elena. Elena, it's nice to have you with us, too.
Thank you very much. That would be nice.
How's everything going on Marcus Welby?
Well, we have a new disease this week.
Oh, you do, huh? Yes. Anything we can mention on the air? Or,
No, you have to wait to see our
one
new
of those,
season.
Huh?
We're going to have a fantastic new season.
Next to Elena and Rosie is the fella the red section is going to be counting on today from Hogan's Heroes and has a new series this next fall called Second Start, Mr. Bob Crane and his actress wife. Okey-dokey. Welcome, all of you. We're all ready to go. Quickies is the name of the game today. Each quickie is worth $150. A little different scoring system. We have $150 in the pot, and I'm reaching for the first quickie now. And here it comes. The question is directed to you, ladies. Don't give me the answer now. Let's say you have a college-age son. He comes home on his vacation with his girlfriend, and he wants to share his bedroom with her. Would you allow it? Let's say you have a college-age son. He comes home on vacation with his girlfriend and he wants to share his bedroom with her. Would you allow it? Think about it, ladies. We'll return in a moment to find out. All right, now, for you and Katie, it's not going to happen at this very moment.
No, we got a couple of years.
But comes a day...
There comes a day in every man's life when he should ask his father, mother, if he can bring his girlfriend home into the bedroom with him.
Yes.
And I say yes.
You say that Katie will say yes?
Yes.
Okay, you say yes. Let's bring on Katie, see what she says. Katie, what's the answer? Well, we know you... This is in the future, of course, but
yes.
Say he comes home and he's got his girl with him. What are you going to say? Yes or no? Can he share his bedroom?
No.
I don't believe it.
Why, Katie?
Well, I just...
She just doesn't want to make up another bed.
I was just going to say, I'm obviously going to still be the housekeeper by that time. And
what?
No.
No. The lady said no.
The lady
I'm sorry,
said no.
There was no score there because Fabian, of course, said yes. Thank you, dear. All right, doctor, what's Elena going to say?
This is getting pretty close to home.
It is, huh?
Elena's an old-fashioned girl, but she'll say yes.
She will say yes, huh? Now, the banana section says... I say the banana section, the yellow section says no. No, they say. You're going to stick with yes, huh? Now, he knows her, remember. He lives with the
fairly
lady.
Fairly well.
She will say yes. Okay, let's bring her on. All right, Elena.
Hi.
You know the question.
Mm-hmm. I know the situation.
You do, huh? He comes home and he has his girl with him. What are you going to say? Yes or no, does he share the bedroom?
I accept them both. Yes.
Yes, that's what the doctor said, too. You're absolutely right. And you have a share of the $150 for your rooting section as well. Thank you, Elena. Okay, Bob, what's Pat going to say?
Well, we've already had to face this. Our 3-year-old shares his room. Our 3-year-old shares it with our maid. And
they get along all right, do they?
Yeah, very well. I mean, he's really turned on. And I believe that Patty is a great lady, and she would say yes.
Okay, let's see if she does. Patty,
yes.
You know the question, you know the situation now. He's home, he's got his girl with him. Yes or no that they share the bedroom?
Well, as the old saying goes, it's his affair. It's none of mine. Yes.
Yes, Dr. They split the $150, $75 apiece, and we'll come back to see how the rest of Tattletales turns out for the day with all 50. See you in a minute. Okay, we're back. Another Tattletale quickie worth $150 for somebody or all of you split three ways. Here it is, ladies. They say that women are hung up on clothes. In your family, who is actually more hung up on clothes, you or your husband? They say that women are hung up on clothes, but in your family, who is actually more hung up on clothes, you or your husband? Think about that, ladies. We'll come back in a moment. Oh, the faces were thinking, trying to figure out how they're going to say this. Fabe, what's Katie going to say?
I think she's going to say that it's me. Yeah.
Yeah, because you are really turned out terrifically, I must say.
Thank you.
So you think she will say it's you?
I think she'll
say it. Do you think
that
it is you?
She likes clothes a lot, too, but I think she'll say me.
Okay, yeah, let's bring her on and see if she agrees with that.
I think so.
Okay, Katie.
Gee, it's a tie, but I think Faye will say he is.
That's what she said. You are right. Well, he does dress terrifically. There's no question about it, but you do, too.
He has more opportunity. He really does. He has more opportunity.
Yeah, true, maybe. Okay, well, you're right. You have a share of that $150. Thank you, Katie. Okay, Rosie, what's Elena going to say?
I'm really puzzled because I can hardly get her to buy clothes. She's, and yet I'm afraid she'll fall back on a kind of a stereotype answer and say, I'm a woman and women, etc.
See, there's a psychiatrist at work, folks.
Oh.
Can't you just feel like laying down when he's talking?
Yeah, right. Wait a minute. Rosie, let me get this answer from you, Rosie. I'd like,
come on, Bert.
It's free. Now, what, it all started when I was about five.
I'm not listening.
You're not... He's not listening?
No. No, he's listening.
$50 an hour and he ain't listening, folks. Okay, doctor, what's going to happen?
I think she'll still say she is.
She'll say she is. Is that true? Is that actually... But you think that she'll just say that? I'm just asking for my own point of view.
It's right in the middle. It really
is.
In the middle. I'm not hung up on clothes, but she's so unhung up that I'm afraid...
Yes.
See?
Now,
okay.
You're really
I mean, I'm so mixed up now. But she'll say she
she'll
is.
She'll say she is. Let's bring her on. Okay, Elena.
Yes.
Between the two of you now, which one of you actually is more hung up on clothes?
But, Daddy, this is not the kind of thing you can just answer real fast because it just doesn't work that way. I mean, because I'm not hung up on clothes, but I am hung up on clothes a little bit only because of the nature of the industry that I'm in. But that's the only reason, because otherwise, I mean, honey, it's all wardrobe. Universal.
So
I guess I am.
That's what he said. You're right.
I'm not in love with
I apologize for the time it took us.
What's that?
I apologize for the time it took the two of us.
No. You're right. And you both handled it beautifully, and you are right, and you do have a share of the $150.
Good.
Thank you, Elena.
Yeah.
Okay, Bob, you've had a little time to think about it down there at the end of the line. What's Pat going to say?
And it's really a tough question because I'll go along with the other two on the panel here. We're both in the business, and for that reason, my wife really isn't hung up on clothes for herself. She buys all my clothes because I would dress in nothing at all. Well, not nothing, but
the red section just all went yeah.
I say being a woman, I would say she's forced into saying herself when she really isn't. But she does dress beautifully, and she dresses me too. So I'll say that she's going to say herself.
Well, your wife dresses you beautifully, I must say. She picked out your mommy dressed you today.
My mommy dressed me, and my gloves are tied to my thing.
Okay, you're going to say that Patty will say she is.
Yeah.
Okay, let's bring her on. All right, Patty. Who is it in your house that tends to be more hung up on clothes, would you say?
Well, it's a hard answer because neither of us really are. I don't particularly care about them. I just don't live in a robe or nightgown. But because Bob has a career, and it depends upon a lot, you know, how he looks and how he dresses, I guess... It goes to him.
That's not what the man to say. Sorry, darling.
So am
I. You know, that's the strange thing, honey. We both said the same thing, but we both came up with a different conclusion.
That's right. You said the same thing.
I said you weren't hung up on him either, but you being female.
You never even hang him up, so.
Must have hung up. Good
that's
for you.
That's not what they asked, honey.
Good for you, Patty, but sorry you didn't score. That means $150 is divided between Katie and Fabian, Elaine and Rosie. 75 and 150 respectively. Change places, ladies and gentlemen. We're at the halfway point, and while we are changing places, we will break away from this message for you. Please come back. Think. Hi, we're back. We have changed places. As you can see, I have the ladies with me. The gentlemen are in the back with their headphones on. Everybody's winning money so far. We're having a terrific time today. Three terrific groups backing our celebrity couples. And we're going to try and make them a little happier, because if they're backing our top winning couple today, we're going to add a bonus of $1,000 to their winnings. Okay. Here comes the next question, fellas. It is directed to you. It's worth $150. $150 in the pot. Here it is. Fellas, listen carefully. You pick up a copy of the Reader's Digest. Which of the following articles would you read first? The articles are, 1, are you getting the most out of sex? 2, a sure way to inner peace. 3, you can be a millionaire if you really want to. Those are the three articles. Which one do you read first? First, are you getting the most out of sex? 2, a sure way to inner peace. 3, you can be a millionaire if you really want to. Now think over those choices and we'll come back for your answer in just a moment. Okay. Well, I'm laughing because I see those titles at the market when you go to the checkout stand. Yeah. There it be, and one of them will always catch your eye.
How to diet.
What's that?
The ones how to diet.
Yeah, the diet ones, too. They always have terrifically enticing articles. Now, which one of those three is Fabian going to go for first? most out of sex.
How to get
sure
the
way
most
to inner
out
peace.
Of sex.
You think so,
I
huh?
Think. Gotta hit his eye first. Definitely.
He's going to read that one first for sure.
Why not?
Why not? Okay, let's find out why not. Let's bring him on. Fabe, which one of those three will it be? Getting the most out of sex, a sure way to win her peace, or you can be a millionaire if you really want to?
Oh, Kate and I have been into the meditation thing, and I think inner peace.
Oh, what a terrible contrast.
Tell them what you said, Katie.
I said how to get the most out of sex. I thought that would catch your eye.
No, I get the most out of sex.
I know, but just to make sure, I thought you might want...
Now, we're talking about...
Well said, Fabian.
Just
well
to
said.
To reaffirm yourself.
And then you get back to an inner peace, man.
That's right.
Well, I'm sorry. You said it beautifully, but nevertheless, you did not score.
How poetic.
And we want to thank you for joining us. Elena, what's Rosie going to say?
Well, I think it's very difficult because he doesn't care anything about that inner peace stuff. And
he's a psychiatrist and he's not interested in inner peace.
No, he's a scientist. You know, he doesn't deal in that type of philosophical stuff.
Oh.
He's a real hardcore scientist, sir.
I see.
He's very interested in money as a game, you know, how to maneuver it in the stock market. I guess if he was going to read any three of them, which I doubt he would read anyway, I guess he would go to the millionaire
You
thing.
Can be a millionaire
if
you
really
want to.
If he's really stuck and has nothing else to do.
Okay, you're going to say a millionaire if you really want to is what he's going to read first, right? Okay, let's bring him on. All right, doctor, which one of the three, the most out of sex, inner peace, or you can be a millionaire?
Bert, those are the three most abominable subjects I've ever heard. The first two are sort of skim milk versions of my own profession, so they're out, so I might as well try to be a millionaire.
That's what the lady said. You're right. How about that? Well, very well said, doctor, and very well done. That's exactly what Elena said. You say the first two are kind of skim milk versions of your own profession, huh?
I may have to retract that.
Yes, absolutely. You have a share of the $150 now. Thank you, doctor.
Good.
All right, Patty, what's Bob going to say? Which one of those is he going to read first?
Well, I know which one he's going to read first. he's getting the most out of it already, but he might be afraid he's missed something. He's going to...
look for a few handy hints. He doesn't want to miss anything.
Now, if you said videotape, electronic, sex would have lost after
that.
But he'll anything. Put sex on it. He'll eat it, read it, buy it, anything.
It's funny when
it sells everything.
When I said, Patty, what's Bob going to say? I heard the S's could be heard all around the whole audience going, sex, the sex one, sex one, sex.
They know him already.
Let's bring on Bob. Hello, Bob. How are you there, big fella? Okay, you got the magazine now. Which one of those three articles are you going to read first?
Somehow people are going to think I'm a sex maniac. I would say the one about sex.
That's what Patty said, and you're right. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that means Elaine and Rosie, Patty and Bob are right. They split the $150, $75 apiece. At this point, Katie and Fabian have $75. Pat and Bob have $150. Elaine and Rosie are in the lead with $225. And we'll break away in just a moment, right after this message. We'll be back.
Thank you very much. And here we go, gang. We have a Tattletale Quickie now that is worth $300. Here's the big one, fellas. The question is addressed to you. Anybody can win it. Here it goes. Men sometimes use rough locker room language. Does it bother you when women talk that way? Men sometimes use rough locker room language. Does it bother you when women talk like that? Think about it, fellas, and we'll get back to you. Well, now, they were thinking about it. Interesting. They all... What do you think, Katie? What's Fabian going to say?
It does bother him.
It does bother
yes,
him.
Yes. He's very old-fashioned family, Italian family background, and it... I don't think he wants it to, but I think it definitely disturbs him.
It does, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It does when I do.
He said, now, cut that out. All right, let's bring him on and see what he says. Okay, $300 at stake, Fabian.
Yes.
What's the answer? Does it bother you when women talk that way?
I have to say, honestly, yes.
That's what the lady said. Katie said it, good body, and you're right. Okay, you have got a leg up on that $300. You have a share of it. Thank you. Okay, Elena, what's the doctor going to say?
He doesn't really like it at all. He's tolerant, but it offends him. It does. No, the word is not offensive. I would just say, no, he doesn't like it.
Just say no, he doesn't like
it. No, he doesn't like it.
And that's what you're saying he's going to say.
He really gets a lot of no, he doesn't like it talk around the house.
He does,
Yeah.
Okay. Let's bring him on. All right, doctor, can you hear me?
Yes, I'm here.
What is the answer? Does it bother you when women talk that way?
This is a very tough one for me because it doesn't particularly. Yet, Elena sometimes gets down on the waterfront herself. And she knows that bothers me when it gets that far. It bothers me for her. I don't care about other people. But I tend to be bothered a little when I hear it from her. But I don't think that's the way she's going to answer it.
So what do you... I'm not bothered. Does it bother you when women talk? What is the answer then, Doctor?
But I'm not bothered.
It does not bother you, is what you're saying. All right. Thank you, Doctor. Okay, Patty, what's Bob going to say?
He's a very liberal-minded man, really.
Yeah.
But I know that he really doesn't like it because he likes femininity. And he wouldn't be offended, but he likes women to be ladies, basically. There are times when he loves it, but basically, no, he wants someone to be feminine, and that reduces the femininity.
So you will say that he will say...
No, he doesn't like to hear ladies talking about, like, truck drivers, no.
Okay, let's bring him on and find out if he agrees with you. All right, Bob, what's the answer now? Does it bother you when women talk that way?
being in the business we're in, you know, gung-ho, I don't like my mother talking like that. But then again, I would say no, it doesn't bother me.
I'm sorry, Bob. That's not what Patty said.
Patty said it. Honey?
You don't like your mother talking that way, and you don't like ladies talking like truck drivers.
I know, honey, but when you're an actor on the road, especially with people...
Well, you don't like to hear women... You want a waitress walk up and talk to you in four-letter words? No.
Well...
Rosie, you blew it.
I'm sorry, honey.
I'm sorry, too, Bob. There's no score there, but what that does mean is that Katie and Fabian got it right. They get the whole team in the bounds. Our time is up. They are the winners for today. Katie and Fabian, the big winners. You have won $375. We add $1,000 to that for a total for your ruling section of $1,375. Okay. A blazing finish, and we'll come back with the tail end of Tattletales in just a moment. Okay, we're back. We had a big day today. We had a terrific finish, and Fabian and Katie pulled it out at the end. Listen, why don't you tell us where we can look for you, Fabian, because I know we got some dates.
Okay, July 22nd for 2 weeks in Reno, August 7th for a month, the MGM Grand.
Right.
September 9th in Harrah's Reno.
Right.
Knott's Berry Farms, January 30th.
June
30th, July 1st, 2nd, and 3rd.
We'll be there. We'll all be there looking for you, and we'll hope you'll be here looking for us on Saturday. Great time to say so long till next time, everybody. Thank you.
This is Jack. Love that, Bob? Well, we've got a whole Bob Lovin' Hour with the Newlywed Game, followed by Card Sharks. Coming up next on Game Show Network.
Let's bring on Bob.